I'm good. I miss you very much. I miss our end of the day main office chats where we just kind of collapsed in the chairs and would share funny stories about the day. I think that was starting to become one of my favorite parts of the routine. So I'm glad you can do this. Just a couple questions, and then we'll do like the true confession thing. Again, 100% admitting, this was a great recommendation by you, so shout out to you from the Jimmy Fallon Tonight Show. So what have you been up to? What's one of the things that you appreciate about being home so much?
Wow. I guess I appreciate getting to see my kids more. Mm-hmm. Usually we're so on the go, and even though I go to school with one of my children, I don't really see them that often. So I like that. I've been able to start doing Taekwondo again with my old school in Florida.
Cool.
Because they do it on Zoom. And so every Tuesday I teach Taekwondo again, which is super cool because I really missed it. I didn't realize how much I missed it until I started doing it again. But I've been running, been watching Netflix, playing games. I mean, I think what everybody else is doing.
Yeah. And I do have to say, I very much appreciate our social distance walks, because that is a very nice change of routine, is when we get to meet for a 6 foot apart walk.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. That's a highlight.
Yeah. What's one of the things you miss the most about Henderson? Just being in the actual building.
Oh man, I just miss being around all the students. And I know everybody else has said that too, but it's so true. Like even students that I don't necessarily work with, mm-hmm. Them just stopping and saying hi to me or asking for help or just, waving to me in the hallway. I think that's super cool. So yeah, that's what I miss the most.
Yeah, ditto. I miss my classes, but just like those little moments in, in the halls and the pop-ins and just the change in routine, dance parties with Marshall, all that stuff. So I have two envelopes here. We're going to steal from the True Confessions. So I'm going to read one. I don't know if you want to say choose left hand or right hand. You will then have 60 seconds to ask me questions to figure out if I'm telling the truth or if it's a lie.
Okay.
All right. And I believe you have them too. So do you want me to choose the left one or the right one?
Oh, left one.
Left one? Okay. My mom had to correct me with the TLC song Don't Go Chasing Waterfalls because I thought it said Don't Go Jason Waterfalls.
Did you know a person named Jason Waterfalls?
No, I did not. I thought the song was about a man named Jason Waterfalls that was a love interest, and TLC was very sad about him dying.
Have you ever seen the video?
Yes, and as you recall, they're in that water, right? And they keep having flashbacks to the guy. I thought that was Jason Waterfalls.
Okay, but so you thought it was Don't Go Jason Waterfalls.
First name Jason, last name Waterfalls.
I believe I've seen the video many times because mm-hmm. this was more in my era than your era. I don't remember any male characters in that video.
Are you sure? Because I'm pretty, I have a memory of like at one point during the video they're showing a picture and the picture of the guy, like the guy just fades away from the picture. Maybe I'm thinking of the wrong music video.
I don't know. I'll have to go back and watch this after that. How old were you when this happened?
Actually, I don't remember because it was so embarrassing. We were in the car and I was singing at the top of my lungs, and it was my own mother who had to turn down the radio and ask, "What did you just say?" And that's when I repeated, "Don't go Jason Waterfalls." That's their boyfriend, right?
What kind of car was it?
It was a minivan that had the black stripes on the side with one of those running boards you could step up on too.
Did both doors open on both sides?
No, it just had the one. Only the one side. And it was a sliding door. Nothing automatic. Like, you had to actually lift the handle out and use your own physical strength to slide the door open.
Where were you going when you were singing about Jason Waterfalls?
Back then, it was either always to Walmart for some kind of grocery trip or to soccer practice, because I was a big soccer player back in the day.
Fascinating.
That was an extra detail that I just thought I'd throw in there. So, Ms. Hollinger, I think we're past our 60 seconds. Do you think this actually happened, or am I making it up?
I think that actually happened.
It did happen. It totally happened, and it was so embarrassing. Because it was my sister was in the car, and she started laughing. My mom has never let me live it down. And still, to this day, when that song comes on, my family just slowly turns to me. And they're like, so how's Jason Waterfalls these days? And I'm like, all right, I get it. I get it. Nice. Well done. Well done, Ms. Hollinger. Actually, an update on my misinterpretation of lyrics. You know that song, I Believe in Miracles?
Uh-huh.
Up until... I want to say it happened 2 months ago, maybe 3 months ago. So this year, maybe late 2019, I 100% thought the lyric was, I believe in mail call. Like that it's about a delivery, like a mail delivery person. I believe in mail call. So like this person was in love with their letter carrier. just as an update. Okay.
In my head, I went to the next lyric and... Right. I'm not sure that really
I think the next out. Lyric is turn around. So again, I'm like, oh, they're walking away with the mail. They want to have a conversation with their mail. Okay. It's just, I guess I just need to listen more closely, I guess, when I'm listening to music. All right. So you have envelopes. Is that correct?
I do.
Okay.
Mine, you know, I don't do right. I have A and B.
Let's go B. Envelope B, please.
Are you ready?
Yes.
All right. In seventh grade, my science partner spilled our experiment all over me, and I had to borrow a shirt from the nurse. It had a cat and flowers on it and said, life is perfect.
Oh, man. And that's in middle school?
Seventh grade.
That's brutal. What was the experiment you were running? Do you remember, like, what the substance was that spilled?
Yeah, actually, it was more like, I said experiment, but it was more like we had to, like, dissect, and we were dissecting a pig's heart.
Oh. Were you dissecting when it happened, or was your lab partner?
I was, and I had put the scalpel into the pig heart. We had to cut it open, and, like, stuff just, like, gushed everywhere, and then she, like, knocked it over. It was, like, in a little tray, and she, like, knocked it into my, like... lap.
Were you immediately mad or were you understanding?
Oh, I was grossed out. Like, I didn't even like dissecting things.
Mm-hmm. Did you cry?
I didn't cry. I was super embarrassed though, because I had like pig fluids on me, and then I had to wear that stupid cat t-shirt.
What shirt were you wearing that got stained and ruined? What was on that shirt?
You know what? I don't know. You know when I was in seventh grade? 1987. So that was a long time ago.
Yeah, yeah.
And so I really honestly don't remember what shirt I had on.
Do you remember the teacher's name?
I think it was Miss Nave.
Miss Nave, interesting. Okay.
N-A-V-E.
Excuse me, I think my 60 seconds are up. I'm going to guess that did not happen.
You're right, it didn't.
Yes! Woohoo! Was the whole nice thing a lie?
What?
Was the whole thing made up or was some of it truth?
Well, we did dissect stuff. Mm-hmm. And I think Miss Nave was my eighth grade science teacher, but I don't remember. Oh, no, my seventh grade was Mr. Buckenberger.
Well, great name.
Just came to me.
Great name.
That's his legit name.
Oh, that was awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah, I remember the days of lab dissecting. Good times, good times. All right, well, Ms. Hollinger, thank you so much. Before we wrap up, is there anything you would like to say to the kids or the community of Falls Church?
I would just say, number one, stay active. You know, I mean, it's easy to just sit in your house, but find things, reasons to go outside. And because I think being outside makes a huge difference. Mm-hmm. Just like... and being outside in nature and being happy. Obviously, stay safe when you go out there. And also, my other thing is, you know, be gracious to those around you, those in your house or your neighbors, or this is affecting people differently. And so some people may not be as kind as they normally are. Just keep that in mind that, hey, you know, everybody's going through something, and, you know, be there for your friends, be there for your family, and be there for your neighbors.
That is very, very well said. Compassion can go a long way. I know I've been guilty of that, where my patience level has gone down, and I just kind of remind myself I'm not the only one going through all of this. So thank you so much.
Oh, you're welcome.
And we'll wrap it up there. I hope you have a lovely day, and thank you so much for appearing on the show.
Oh, you're welcome.
Bye, Ms. Hollinger.
See you later.
Hello. Good. How are you?
I am very, very good. I miss you a lot. Amazing sweatshirt. I just got to say, that's awesome. Thank you for wearing that. How have you been? What have you been up to?
I've been great, actually. My family is home because some of my brothers are usually at college, so they're home. I've been playing a lot of basketball, lots of video games too, just like most people.
Yeah. That's awesome. I'm glad you're getting outside. And yeah, we were talking earlier. I'm like, the NBA needs to be ready for Billy Aisel next year. Just saying, I'm calling it first. And I'm his agent, for the record. I get 10%. Agent. We'll talk about it later. What's one of the things that you really miss about being just at Henderson?
It's been really lonely. Obviously, you realize once you get out of school that a lot of your friends are what you could call school friends, mm-hmm. where just when you're in school, you're always talking to them. But once you get out, you're like, I don't have really any way to connect to them. It's really weird.
Yeah, especially when, you know, you're being told to stay home. And even if you do go out, you got to keep that 6-foot distance. It's just very, very bizarre times right now. I don't know about you, but I've been watching just like various like reality TV and movies. What's been something that you've been watching that you maybe want to recommend to those of us out there looking for something to watch?
I know a lot of people probably watch this like 3 times, but I've been watching The Office again. I just finished that.
So good.
Obviously the Michael Jordan documentary is going on right now.
Mm-hmm.
And I really recommend that. It's really good.
Yeah,
to
that's
watch.
Been awesome, especially with no sports, aka playoff hockey. That would be happening right now.
Mm-hmm.
For the record, I'm just going to call it. If it were happening, I'm sure the Capitals would be doing very well and on their way to the Stanley Cup. Just saying.
Yeah.
So what's one of your like favorite snacks to have when you're watching The Office?
I have ramen just about every day.
Do you really?
My mom bought the huge case of just ramen. It was like selling like 2 ramen packets high and then like the like 4 across and like selling like 20 wide. I don't know. There's so many.
Man, you're going to do so well in college, Billy. Like you're already preparing yourself for college living or like the life of an actor. Just saying, like you're ready.
That and unusual, but I've been eating cereal with chocolate milk instead.
Oh, good call, man. I think the only time I've come close to that is when I have the chocolate Rice Krispies or Cocoa Puffs, and the milk just like naturally gets chocolatey.
Oh, well, I eat chocolate milk with rice with regular Rice Krispies.
Very nice combo. So speaking of your sweatshirt, since you were involved with Mary Poppins this year, which again, I'm so thankful we were able to perform it before all of this happened, because you guys put so much hard work into that, so many hours of rehearsal. Is there either like a really funny blooper or favorite moment that you'd be willing to share with us from your experience in that show?
Blooper, I know a lot of people saw this. The final show, I happened to run out on stage just a few seconds early. Oh my, that was embarrassing. And so many of my friends were right in the front row. I ran out. I realized no one was behind me. And everyone just stares at me. I'm like, oh, no.
It's like deer in the headlights. Like, oh no. Yeah.
And I just sprint back. That and, you know, just getting to know everyone. A lot of the main cast and crew, there was a lot of 8th graders. And since they're not in my grade, I don't really know them outside of the play, but to get to know them was really nice. They're really cool.
Yeah, that I have to say, that's one of my favorite things as a director, is kind of watching that group who starts as these kind of like split grade levels become this one big happy family at the end. Well, Billy, I just want to thank you so much, because I know you were a very busy online student these days. So thank you for making an appearance on the show. And before we part ways, is there anything you would like to say to the community? Any words of wisdom or any advice for us?
I'd say just it helps to find something that you like to do and just keep on doing that and get really good at it.
Awesome. Great advice, Billy. Thank you so much. And I will definitely be talking to you soon.
Yep. See
All right.
ya.
Take care. Bye, Billy.
Bye.
Thank you.